My name is Charles.
Hello, Charles.
I'm for a number of years. I'm from New York. Originally went to school up there. Had a lot of neuromuscular, shiatsu, polarity, zero balancing, all kinds of stuff like that. And I've been doing therapy for a number of years. I don't tell you how many zeros after the two, but a number of years. And I enjoy it a little bit more. What do you think massage therapy is about? Or what do you think massage therapy is about? Anybody?
Making people feel better.
Okay. And we're making them feel better because what are we trying to do? That's our...
Release tension?
Release tension, stress relief. Okay. And how do we do that? By our attitude, our approach, our attention, how we apply the technique, etc. We'll be talking about Coach decided to do an energy day today. Apparently, you're doing a lot of book work.
No.
Not really? But maybe just an energy day to give you guys a break. You've done chakra balancing already, so you know that. I'm going to add to that chakra balancing. We'll talk about chakras and nadis from Ayurvedic medicine. It's about 72,000 or 350,000 channels that run through your body, depending on which text you need. We'll talk about the electromagnetic currents, five that run through our body. Particularly with the root chakra, which helps us to ground into the earth. I found this book over here. If you want to look at it, if you get a chance. It's called Earthing. And it's really about grounding into the earth. One of the things that we are missing in our society. So if you look around the room, what are we wearing?
Shoes.
And what are we standing on? Sitting on? Concrete, basically. We're not touching the earth, right? Our bare feet are not on the earth. Now, recommends work for walking in the grass, which is good. Walking in the grass for the dew in the morning, which has a good balance and gravity. Cold water, cold shower, so when you do a massage, you release the energy from the elbows down. Cold water helps the ground you as well. Drinking water. Now, the caveat I would say about the walking on grass is make sure you find a patch of grass if you can that doesn't have herbicides or pesticides or it's a dog area. Dogs are walking on common. But the sand, the beach, anybody go to the beach? Walk barefoot on the beach? Oh, great, excellent. Beach is great because one, what's happening to the foot? It's moving. It's moving to the natural movements of the foot, which we really don't get with our shoes. We get this, we call this dorsiflexion, plantar flexion. So this is the foot, it's the ankle, dorsiflexion, plantar flexion. But we don't get the inversion, eversion as strongly if we're barefoot on uneven surfaces. So we really get that exercise. And if you look, do you have bones in here? Plus, you used to have bones. So, when we're walking, this is an effect called the venous pump, this movement. Like, if you ever, when I was growing up, we had a pump, get our water, we had to really do it by hand, pump our water in, to plug our own well. And when you're doing this walking, you're actually pumping that blood and that lymph back towards the heart. And a lot of times, because we don't get that inversion, we're not connected electromagnetically to the earth, it doesn't work as well. The circulation is compromised. So walking, sometimes called the exercise of genius. Because when you walk, typically when you crosswalk, what happens? We know the right side of the hemisphere, the brain, controls the left side of the body, the left side, the right side. So when we're walking, we're actually creating neural connections, new neural connections. And we stop walking, those neural connections start to break down. And of course, we have how many cells in our body? We just started cells, about 100 trillion cells, 300 trillion cells, depending on which text you read. Well, part of those cells, of course, are your brain cells. And you have approximately 10 billion or so, 20 billion brain cells. And those neural connections being created and disconnected, or connected and disconnected all the time, depending on how we use our bodies and how we use our minds as well. So getting connected to the earth, if you can, is a great way of grounding. We'll do some other type of grounding today as well. Have you started the bones? No. No? Okay. Here are the bones in this closet. So you've done the chakra balancing. Okay. Before we get into that, let's go around the room so I can get your names in my head. And we'll start over here.
Sebastian.
Sebastian?
Yeah.
Okay. And why did you come into massage therapy?
Because something I want to do, and I want to help, like helping people and stuff.
Helping people?
Making them feel better.
Any particular type of modality you thought of or approach?
I want to get to the sport area part of it.
Sports?
Yeah.
Okay, sports massage, good. So you want to work with athletes, amateur, professional? Okay, anybody can benefit from sports massage. All right, and how do you feel about this one?
I just want to align.
Align?
Yeah, doing my research.
Oh, okay. You know anybody who's a therapist?
No.
Not personally. Okay, so Sebastian.
Yes, sir. Michael?
Michael.
Mm-hmm.
And why are you here, buddy?
I mean, like, kind of like the same as him, trying to see if I could go for, like, sports medicine.
Sports medicine. Okay, excellent. Great growing field. Right. Any particular idea where you would go for sports medicine?
Athletic trainer.
Athletic trainer.
Yeah.
Okay. Athletic trainers. Glad you brought that up. Now, athletic trainers, you want to work for a team?
Mm-hmm.
Professional team? Okay. They can do massage. They don't need a massage license. They're one of the few exceptions. A doctor, for instance. Except does not have to have a massage license to perform massage. Doesn't mean they're any good at it. Just don't have to have a license, separate license, because their license covers the practice of massage. And for like trainers, they can do massage techniques. And you know any athletic trainers?
Not too much.
Not too much. You've seen them work sidelines?
Some of them.
Yeah, they are working with athletes, obviously, so it's very, very important that those athletes stay healthy. And they're looking at, obviously, strains or sprains, so inflammation, etc.
Mm-hmm.
All right, very good. And then we have Sebastian Michael, Sebastian Michael, and...
Narish.
Narish?
Yes.
Yeah.
Narish. N-A.
Narish.
N-A.
N-A. Narish. Narish. Okay. And what brought you here?
Well, mostly just fascinated by, like, you know, how they approach, how you're able to do certain stuff to cure the body without using, like, all these crazy drugs or stuff like that.
Yes. Yes, our bodies naturally produce hormones. And our bodies produce the hormones in the exact proportion or ratio that we need at that particular moment. We have neural neuropeptides. You'll be learning about neuropeptides, cortisol hormones, neurotransmitters, which actually help the nerves transmit messages from one part of the body to another, from the brain, let's say, to the foot. And those are basically electrochemical in nature. So chemicals, we are a chemical factory, yes. And it's obviously better if we produce it rather than taking synthetic. Yes. You can have a very powerful effect with massage because you do change the physiology. You do affect the physiology through the anatomy. When you touch the skin, you learn that the skin is the largest organ in the body. Yes. So the skin is really a sensory organ. It's our boundary between the inside world, quote unquote, and the outside world. It's like a cell. Remember cell membrane? Well, cell membrane is basically a little boundary between the inside of that cell and the outside of that cell. And on that cell membrane, you can have receptors. And those receptors responding to those neurotransmitters, hormones, neuropeptides, what I was talking about, which are greatly influenced and modulated. Regulated by massage, by stress reduction, for instance. So massage is a great license to have because it's such a wide, wide umbrella. You can do things like energy work, you can do things like sports massage, neuromuscular, you name it, A to Z, zero balancing, Z, zero balancing, A, acupressure. A to Z, it's all covered underneath massage license. Hopefully it stays that way. All right, so you knew anybody in massage therapy? Okay, how'd you hear that?
Well, I originally applied to the PTA program, and she sent out like a mass email saying that it complements physical therapy, stuff like that. And
oh, so you can do this and then PTA after?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I know a number of my friends are PTAs or PTs and therapists, and the friends that are acupuncturists, chiropractors, osteopaths, are also licensed massage therapists as well. Some started massage therapy and then went to others. Some became a doctor and then became a therapist, which is kind of interesting. But it's a way of working with the body that's really very natural. Right? It's really instinctive in us. There's an old saying by Plato, all learning is remembering. So ideally, we really know all this stuff inside. Right? We've just forgotten. So part of this is remembering who we are, what we are, why we're here. Because massage not only affects just the body, it's body, mind, spirit, soul. It's all interconnected, you can't separate. Alright, so say it one more time.
Think about the nourish part.
Well, let me hear from
nourish.
Nourish. Okay, nourish. N-A-R-I-S-H.
Huh? R-I-S-H.
R-E-S-H. R-E-S-H.
Yeah, it's N-A-R-E-S-H.
Okay, nourish.
Yeah, there you go, you got it right the second time.
I got it
the
right.
Second.
Okay. Hope it's on tape. All right, next.
Patricia.
Yes. So I like the rich, but Patricia.
There you go. Yeah. And same as my friend here, I also applied for the PTA program.
Okay, great.
And since I was not accepted, I also had in mind to do the massage therapy. Right now, I've never had a massage before, so all this is brand new to me, and I'm amazed, actually, like you said. There's many areas where you can work, and I've never heard of the Ayurveda.
Yes.
Medicine, so it's amazing to me all that I've learned so far, too. I've worked in a physical therapy clinic before, and they used to do lymph drainage.
Yes.
The PT used to do it, so I found that very interesting. So that could be an area that after I finish with the massage therapy, that I would like to work.
Oh,
as well.
great work, yes.
Yeah.
Lymphedema.
Exactly.
Swedish massage, most other types of massage, except maybe Polari. but lymphedema, you want to do lymphatic drainage or drainage. You have manual lymph drainage, water technique, and you have Chicpee method, which is the lymphatic drainage. It's called drainage because he's French. And really, it would be recommended to do lymphatic drainage for anybody with lymphedema. Somebody could have one lymph node removed, right? And then they have this arm swelled up, sometimes 3, 4, or 5 times more than normal. That's the lymph fluid. So you can really create a connection with that. There's no cure for it, but it's really beneficial. I'm sorry?
I said we used to have lots of patients coming in.
Yes. Did they have surgeries?
Yeah. Leg hurt, swollen.
Ah, yes. So that's great work. And some great good friends. Well, they descended, but you have some great friends with them. All right, so that's Patricia.
Yes.
And we have?
Kimberly.
Kimberly. Okay.
A lot of people have told me, like, I give good massages. So I decided to come in Broward College because I heard they were going to have like a little class like talking about what the program was about.
Okay, good.
So I came to talk to Sandra and then I got into the program.
Good. Now, she prefer you call her Sandra or coach?
Coach.
Coach, okay. I call her coach. Very, very knowledgeable. Not only massage therapy, but she's also an OTA, occupational therapist, a number of things. Ayurvedic, we're talking about Ayurveda. We'll be doing some Ayurvedic techniques in this program as well. Okay, so Kimberly, so you just came for an introduction and you decided to do the program. Okay. Anybody here have any anatomy, physiology background? Two? Okay, from where?
Anatomy and physiology, 1 and 2.
Oh, you stayed college. Okay. So you also have a program.
Yeah, they do. I decided to come here.
Okay. Cool. Welcome. And?
South University.
University?
University. Okay. In West Palm, yes.
West Palm.
Because I was doing the prereqs there for the PTA, and then somebody said, you're wasting a lot of money here. Go to a public school.
Right.
Get the same.
Yeah, that's a great point, isn't it? If you're going to a private school, it could cost you how much? $17,000, $15,000, a lot.
But I have to say, my teacher was excellent for anatomy physiology. She was a PA, and it was so easy to learn with her, just like coach. She had the same approach.
Great. Good.
Was a good investment.
Good. All right, so with Kimberly and then the young lady back here.
I'm Stephanie.
Stephanie.
Yeah.
Okay, you said it had anatomy.
Yeah, I went to Nova Southeastern.
Nova Southeastern. So you have 1 and 2? Okay. You're preparing for something else? Or?
I'm a personal trainer right now, so I feel like this will be a great complement to that.
Definitely. Excellent. Okay. So how did you hear about this particular program?
Researching online, checking out all the different programs, and I felt like this was the most well-rounded one, and when I talked to Coach, she was the most approachable and seemed friendly and knowledgeable, so I chose this one.
Good. Okay, Stephanie. Then we have?
Heather.
Heather. Okay.
I was just interested, and I was looking around at all the different schools and decided this one was the best.
Okay. Well, you did pick a good school. Coach has had a lot of experience. Okay, since we've done this side, what would you
name? My name is Guo.
Guo?
Guo.
Guo.
Yes. Like Guo. Wow,
like
Guo,
wow, but Guo. Wow, Guo. Wow. Okay, and how did you get here?
I transferred from DC. I live in DC before, so I transferred from DC. I was in the program at another college over there.
Okay.
Since I was retired, so I was like, yeah, Florida is a good place to live. So I was like, yeah, I can move to Florida.
Oh, so you're new to Florida?
Yeah, I'm new.
About a month?
Yes, just around a month and a half.
Okay, how do you like it so far?
Not bad, but Florida has his own mind, and so things are probably different.
A little different, yeah. I'm from the north myself. And it took a little while to get used to it.
Yeah.
And I used to work down here in the summer and up north, no, to me, the opposite way. Up north in the summer, down here in the winter. Right? So I was a snowbirder.
Yeah.
Worked in both places, which is a great thing to have, a license in New York and a license here as well. All right, then we'll go back on this side of the room. Come back.
Adani. Yeah.
Close enough?
No, you said it right.
Oh, I did?
Yeah.
Okay, and how did you get here?
Well, I saw the program online, plus I used to go to the school, so, you know, I kind of always thought about massage therapy as something that I would like to do.
Something to check out.
Yeah.
I hear you had 20 people in.
Huh?
You had 20 people at first?
Right.
So now you have 18?
Yeah, it's less than. Mm-hmm. You lost it.
Okay, that's not bad. All right, and any idea what you want to do in this? Or
not really, I'm just kind of still trying to decide like what I would like to, you know, do.
Okay, good. Like you say, you'll be introduced to a lot of different approaches, so you have a wide umbrella to choose from.
Yeah.
Thank you. Now,
Jessica.
Okay, and why are you here?
I just thought that the human body was really interesting, so I wanted to take on like a few different things that like classes that would just like teach me about it. Like I'm like what she's doing, I'm doing like personal training and massage therapy, and then I want to go into sports medicine when I'm older with these athletes.
Great. And any place you want to go for sports medicine? Do you have any idea?
I'm sorry.
Any idea where you're going to go for sports medicine?
FAU.
FAU. All right, great. Cool. Okay. And we have?
Sarah. Yeah.
Okay, my shirt.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I decided on massage therapy because I actually want to get more into energetic work.
Okay.
But I thought that this was a good place to start to get into contact with people and their bodies. And I was really happy when I stumbled across this course because, like you think, Florida has its own mind. I think it's a bit of devoid of a lot of spirit and like substance. And then when I came, I was quite randomly in Fort Lauderdale. And I'd been looking at places and was really disgruntled because everything seemed just like, I don't know, cookie cutter box.
Yeah.
And
spread
then,
it, sprawl.
Yeah, and then they were having an open day here, and I came up, and within 10 minutes, Ms. Stone had mentioned, a whole variety of stuff that I was just like, oh, perfect, so it worked out really well that I could come to the course, that I stumbled across it, because I hadn't, and I've been here for 4 months.
4 months?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm glad you made it. Do you do yoga?
Yeah.
Okay, are you a teacher, or?
No, that's like
extending the teaching with yourself.
Yeah, I've just spent a lot of time. I should have done my teaching course. I spent a lot of time with Mexico here in meditation retreats and stuff.
Wonderful. Where are you from?
South Africa.
South Africa, okay.
Yeah.
Great. Alright, and then we have
Helen.
Helen, okay. Good. And
Good morning.
So what brought you here? How did you
get here? I tried to put on the physique program, but I didn't get accepted. So I came in from the class. I'd always be given
one of the
stuff
I figured,
why not?
Might as well learn
something.
So. Learn something?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you been drawn to massage before then, or just?
I have been drawn to massage. Like I was going to do nursing, and then I changed my mind to massage, but then I'm like, that's just a different deal. I wanted to get a degree also, and that's why I went for the BTA.
Right.
But it didn't work out, so I can do it.
Okay. Okay.
You have an MBA program, so you can find it goes up to the other programs.
Okay. Wonderful. There is a lot of anatomy here. The body, somebody mentioned the body is another thing, which is amazing. Which is amazing. You're learning the layers of the body. And like we say, we just don't work on the body, but we touch something on it. For instance, we have the heart. When you get into meridians, talk about the heart chakra, the pericardium. The pericardium happens to empty out along with the heart into your hands. So when you're actually touching someone, basically you're connecting your heart, your heart energy, with that individual. You're connecting the electromagnetic currents, what we're talking about later on, the elements. So it's many, many layers, a lot too. It can be very simple, it's very natural. Like we say, Plato said, all learning is remembering. So we're trying to remember all this. We already know. Some level. Okay, now we're up to
Sebastian.
Sebastian.
Yes. Sebastian. Sorry, Sebastian.
Yeah, it's two. Okay. And we didn't talk, but how did you get here?
Really by accident or by chance. I had no knowledge of massage prior to it as a profession. I've never had one done. I was on the internet and I came across, I think, a Yahoo article. They had some careers on there. They mentioned massage. And I found it interesting because I was doing nursing prior to this at the Central campus. And then I ended up withdrawing because I decided it wasn't going to be for me. And I still wanted to do something in healthcare because I became very interested and fascinated into holistic medicine and living a healthy lifestyle, which is something I incorporate in my daily life. So I found this, and I started reading up about it, and I came, like Sarah did, to the orientation. And I found Coach to be very informative and personable, and I liked him so far. I'm very pleased with my decision.
Yeah, holistic is a derivative of, spell it this way, holistic. Okay. Whole and or holy. Again, you work in body, mind, soul, and spirit.
Yeah. Something I really like because I used to do martial arts when I was younger, so Taekwondo, I did that for many years. And so I don't know, I guess that had influence on me. I still practice it today, not as much as I used to, but I'm very much into things like that.
Very cool. Yeah. Meditation?
Yeah, for me, that's definitely a form of meditation, yeah. Therapy.
Moving meditation.
Movie meditation, yeah.
Right.
So when she mentioned the Tai Chi, that's something I would like to take up because it's similar, it's related to what I do.
Yeah, I'm looking around the room. It used to be a Tai Chi.
Sure.
Downstairs?
No, it's just down there.
Oh, it's down there.
Okay.
Oh, yes, I see. Yeah, when you do meditation, you know, it's more than just this, right? You have open-eye meditation, looking at a sunset, sunrise, looking at the coming of the ocean. Or you do the closed-eye meditation, right? The moving meditation, Tai Chi, Qigong. Contemplation is a type of meditation. We do something we enjoy, love. That's a type of meditation. We do meditation all the time. Just whether we're consciously aware of it. All right. Okay, Sebastian. Hang out.
Brian.
Okay. I had a Brian Blue. I used to teach two evening classes here a couple years ago. I used to teach down at the Technical Center for 12 years or so on the street. So I'm still on the same street. So Brian, I had my students' evening used to sit right there. It's also Brian. So what brought you here, Brian?
Back in high school, I was part of a program for firefighting. And they taught us EMT stuff and everything was medical. But 3 years into the program, I just decided that it wasn't for me.
3 years?
Yeah. That I didn't want to be firefighting as a career for this. So I still do some of the medical of EMT, and that was like cool. And massage therapy, I thought was like nice to know how to, and like it would be like a good career to like not I still help people from like firefighting, but not, you know, running like a burning building every day. So I just thought it'd be cool and that I knew medical and that was cool.
So cool. Thank you, Brian. All right, we have
Danielle.
Actually, 10 years ago, I took the massage therapy course.
10 years ago?
Yeah, I passed the course. There was some confusion. I thought I was licensed to work, and I really wasn't. But I've been interested in massage since I was very little. I would massage my mom. I grew up with it. Like, we just grew up with massage around us. We massage our babies. If you're stuck with tummy problems, you should massage your stomach. Like, we just grew up with it. The last course I took really opened me up to energy work, and I was very interested in it. So the director of the last school told me about Ms. Stone, and he was actually one of her students. So I mean, long story short, I was working as a therapist. I know it's legally, but and I got in a car accident and I hurt my forearm, and so I just stopped. And then the 5 years passed. I didn't meet the VCUs,
right.
So I just thought I had children, and I think it's a good way for me to have hours flexibly enough where I could kind of stay home or homeschool if I wanted to. And so I decided to do the course over again, so to prepare me for taking.
All right, so 10 years ago, you graduated, took your board. Did you take the NCE, National Certification?
Yeah.
Okay, now we also have the MBLEX.
Yeah.
Which is usually what's recommended because it's more entry level. But the NCE is more traditional Asian medicine, learning meridians, emotions, and organs, meridian organs. What was it?
It was MedVance.
MedVance.
I don't know if they're still there,
if
another school is there.
Okay. And one of your instructors was a student
here? Yeah, Valentino.
Valentino?
Yes.
Okay. Welcome. You'd be great help, great resource for everybody.
I'll try.
So you have anatomy, physiology.
Yeah, I have a pretty good understanding of it. Yeah. It's a lot of remembrance.
Right. Well, Plato said it all. Learning is good. Okay, then we have
Serena.
Yeah. Okay, what brought you here, Serena?
I worked in the spa industry for about over a year. But I wasn't really interested in massage therapy while working there. So towards the end, after I quit the spa industry, I decided that I want to go to school for massage therapy, but really I'm more into, because I was a spa coordinator, I was a massage therapist, so I was kind of like running the place, helping
right.
run the place, so I'm more into running the place, like opening up my own business, not so much of working as a massage therapist forever.
Right.
That's what I'm like.
Other people work for you.
Yeah.
That's how you make the money.
Yeah.
Because you can only do so many of them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's work. Depending on what type of work, you know, if you're doing neuromuscular, I first started out doing neuromuscular tissue stuff, you know, forearms and all that, and working with athletes, football players up in New York, baseball players, with PGA, Women's Professional, WPGA, Women's Professional Golf Association, a number of their players. And do the tissue is, I mean, you really have to watch your body mechanics. I made a big mistake when I first started. I was a supervisor at a little spa up in the Boca area. And I was working 7 days a week, 8 to 10 hours a day. And after a while I said, well, if I keep this up, I'm not going to make coming up, one of those statistics, the average career of a licensed massage therapist is about 5 years. And one of the reasons is injury, right? Overworking. One of the things you have to be able to say in this business is no. No one say yes, but if you're tired, right, and you feel like you're going to be upset, find the chance to be less in front of a mind when you're tired, and ask when you get more chance to help yourself. So, you've already done 6 massages. That's all I have to say. Now, spa. You schedule appointments?
Yeah.
Okay. How many appointments was typical therapist doing in the spa?
A lot. Like, we're really busy. Like, sometimes they'll have, like, back-to-back, and
yeah.
They'll have a little lunch and a little berry lunch.
If they were lucky.
Yeah. So they'll be, like, really tired sometimes, you know? And then some of them, like, they want to do it. They're like, yeah, book me. Like, you know, they want the money, of course. They're making money. It's not free. But at the same time, it's like, you get tired. And someone put their hand before, you know, their shoe was out of work, like a week,
yeah.
You know, and
that's
the thing, like your hands, like you need your hands,
yeah.
And your hands, your friends, they work, but they're really tired sometimes.
So how many things a day was average?
For like one person?
Yeah, one person.
During the shift, it depends the time of working. Sometimes one per time. Like, if you're working like 4 hours, you have about maybe 5.
Okay.
If you're working like full time, you have 8, like you say. That's a lot because some of them, they're not just Swedish. Sometimes they're an hour and a half or
right.
Sweet Thai or.
Right.
I'm just tiring.
Yeah, it is very tiring. It is like an athlete. You're not running, you know, 100-yard dash, you're not catching a football and you tackle. But you are using your body in a way that you're not used to.
Yeah. They were, like, really healthy, though. They started making me eat really healthy because a lot of them were eating really organic food and some of them were vegans. I mean, I'm not a vegan. I can never be a vegan. But I was changing, huh? But no, I was changing, like, the way I eat and everything. I was eating, like, more vegetables and things like that, so... That kind of, you know, I like that. That influenced me to eat better. So, yeah, it was good. I mean, they need to be healthy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's one thing, I brought that up. One of the things, this is really a health, in the health field.
Yeah.
A health practitioner. All right. Now, even though, you know, as a massage therapist, you know, there is a doctor, you know, there somewhere. But we really can help people. With massage therapy, and we have to take care of ourselves first. You know, most of us, we could say we like to help people. You know? We're givers. That's great, but we also have to take time for ourselves first. We can't. It's like the old saying: you know, in order to love someone else, we have to love ourselves first, because our love comes out from within. It doesn't go out in. So we have to be balanced, taking care of ourselves, grounding ourselves, doing maybe a little stretching between sessions. And sometimes, as you say, you can have back to back. When are you going to go to the restroom? When are you going to eat? When are you going to drink water? So it can be a big challenge. That, of course, you've got to change the linen, clean the table up, put new linen on, get ready to take it in. When you do 50 an hour, say 50 minutes.
Right? 50 minutes. Well, actually, the spot is working with 60 minutes. Yeah, it's either like 60 minutes or 90.
Or 90.
Yeah. And some people add like extra things. So sometimes you spend like at least almost two and a half hours with one person because they want to scrub and all that stuff. Yeah. It makes your time go faster.
Yeah. Ideally, energetically, we ground ourselves, when we work on someone else, we're actually receiving more of ourselves. If we don't stay stagnant, even while I'm just sitting in my friend's sacral, long as I do like real minute movements, right, I won't get stiffen up. Circulation will still flow. Right? You sit for a long time, it happens to the blood, things are cool. Right? But if you're doing Swedish, you know, you're moving. Right? You're almost doing like a Tai Chi. So it's very advantageous for you to be health conscious. Now, we recommend clients, you know, hydrate. Right? Why do we recommend they hydrate? You can't prescribe it, right? You can't tell them. You got to control it because we're not doctors. You can't diagnose any of that. But we can recommend, suggest, and even, you know, some more. And water doesn't mean tea or coffee or beer or wine. Why do we water? That's important stuff.
The body's made of it. The body's made of it.
Source of energy?
The body's made of it. Majority of the body's made of it.
Yeah, the body's primarily water. Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you look at the chart, you're only 70% or more water. And when we do fascia work, we work the muscles, which are wrapped in fascia. Right? Fascia can be in two states. It can be in a gel state, which means stuck, sticking together. So the venous soul state is more liquid. We want that to be more in a liquid state, but in order to help that, enhance that treatment, and they hydrate, that helps that tissue to stay in that soul state. And we really, we can look at ourselves, look at our bodies, showing a little bit of the skeleton, that the skeleton in our fascia, bone is a type of connective tissue, as well as fascia is a type of connective tissue. Our blood is a type of connective tissue. We're basically a liquid crystalline structure. Right? And we're basically exposed, taking in all these energies all around us. And sometimes the energies are not as balanced as we'd like them to be. The EMFs, electromagnetic frequencies, quote unquote. But we can still maintain our balance by balancing ourselves. Now, if we're balanced, and we put our hands on someone, then that's going to help them to find their balance. Mm-hmm. Now, we're not going to balance them. They're going to balance themselves. But there's a thing called entrainment, that, like music. You listen to music, and you're sort of, you know, getting trained into music. You feel the rhythm. Well, the same thing, what we do in massage, there's a rhythm to it. There's a movement to it, energetically, circulation, and new. And we can entrain, or your client can entrain with you, quote unquote, being the balanced person in the session. Because our client, we assume, just came out of 95 traffic, or just had an accident, and we're like, stressed out. Or they're very busy at work, or the deadline's at work, so they're stressed out. Our job, one of our main jobs, is to help to de-stress that individual. And just by doing that, that brings the body back into a balance. Talk about that word, that it's a relative constancy of the internal environment, homeostasis. Okay, homeostasis is what the body always wants to achieve, balance. And our job is to help them. Now, what we're going to do is a little
meditation.
Right now, we're going to do like a little meditation. So what we're going to do is have our feet flat on the ground. Palms are open. Place an open palm. And can somebody hit one of those lights? Turn them off. Now, when your knees below your hips, basically help stretch the psoas muscle. Right, so what we're going to do is close your eyes, and you're just going to feel what's happening in your body, any awareness, areas of awareness in your body. And you want to breathe in. In the nose and out the mouth. And you want to notice anything in your bodies?
Me, I always, when I wake up, I always have like back pains in the back. But I noticed when I did that, like, it went away.
Excellent.
Yeah, it went away.
So I didn't meet you, did I?
No.
What's your name, sir?
John.
John.
Yes, sir.
Great. Thank you, John. That's the energy. That's just the energy moving. Okay, anyone else?
I finally stopped thinking because my mind races a lot. I think about, like, many different things all day.
Yeah.
So it's nice. It's peaceful. I didn't think about anything.
Didn't think about anything?
No.
Oh, right. That's what we call it. John. Because our minds are very busy. We're always thinking about something.
Yes.
All right, anyone else? Have you noticed any warmth, any tingling? We go downstairs. One of the techniques we'll be doing is called a resting position on the client. It's a way of for us to connect with the client. The client gets used to our touch. At the same time, it's also very common for the client. It's also very common for us as well. It's just like a resting position. We're doing the chakra routine again today. We'll add a little bit to that. Anyone else? All right, can somebody hit the legs? Maybe just the back legs. One leg. Together. All right, so you did the chakra routine. How many chakras were there?
Seven.
Now, depending on which source you read, it might be 12. Barbara Brennan, Hands of Light, talks about 21, major and minor. But in every joint, quote unquote, in every Zumbo point, every Mama point, Zumbo points are like acupressure points, they're really, in effect, like a chakra, minor chakra. But we talked about the major chakras, and these are wheels. Chakra means wheels, or vortex of energy. And what they do is like they take the energy out there from the macrocosm, or the microcosm, a reflection of the macrocosm, takes the energy and steps it down, like say the macrocosm to 220 voltage, steps it down to 1 to 10 so we can, our bodies could handle it. Earth, the root chakra, you ever have your feet on the ground when you do massage, usually your feet are on the ground, unless you're on a table, you can do it on a table, walking on the ground, for instance, you might have bars. I'll lose your balance. Whenever you walk on the earth, it's through your root chakra, through the kidney meridian. Here's the plantar surface. Kidney one is called the bubbling brook. This helps you connect right into the earth. Mother Earth, like Father Sky. The way you're saying that is yang yin. Now, nadis are channels like the meridians are channels. Now, meridians, typically, we learn about 14 meridians, 12 major regular organ meridians, related to your lungs, large intestines, right, stomach, and spleen, liver, gallbladder, etc. And those in them have extraordinary vessels, like your central, great central, your conception, and your governing vessel. You ever hear of the microcosmic orbit? Okay, this is basically where the chakras are, right in the center. So the great central channel from TCM is the Asian version, Chinese version. We say traditional Chinese medicine, we're talking Chinese, Japanese, Korean, etc. So it's also known as traditional or Asian medicine, if you would be more inclusive. but the great central channels conception and governing is really that medicine work example or variation on the chakras, which is also right in the center. And the chakras in the front and the back. We'll be working with the magnetic currents, the elements. You've heard of ether, air, fire, water, earth. We've been working with those. You've heard of zone therapy. Okay. How many fingers and toes do we have?
All together.
20. Okay. So we have 5, 5, 5, 5. All right, but if we just look at one side, then we have 10 fingers, 10 toes together. So that's each one of those fingers and toes represents a zone. So we have 5 in the hand, 5 in the foot. Thumb, which is the pollex, and the big toe, which is the hallux, have all 5 of those zones in those digits. In supraclavicular region above the shoulder line, i.e. the clavicles, all 10 zones are included in the neck. They all come up over the neck. So we've been talking about this. Zone therapy is really energetic in the fact that anybody have an awareness anywhere in their body, you have the back. All right, so let's say John, we're working on him. We can work anywhere in that zone, not necessarily on that particular area. We can work anywhere in that zone, and that would affect the imbalance to that area. Let's say it was inflammation, it was an injury, you couldn't touch it, it was a regional contraindication. So you can work elsewhere to have a slight effect on that area of the body. We can work ipsilateral, which means the same side, or we can work contralateral, which means the opposite side, and still have an effect. Because everything's connected. Zero balancing. HMV means a half moon vector. We'll start that before we do the chakra. Basically, it's creating a traction, but a curved traction. Looking at the body, you look at charts, you look at the skeleton. The spine's not straight, is it? It has curves in it. So do a curved traction, very gently. Okay, that. And a lot of times, of course, in no cells make up what?
Tissues.
Tissues make up.
Tissues.
Organs. Organs make up organ systems.
Organ systems.
And which makes up the body as a whole. Well, when we do therapy, we're really working at a cellular level, actually looking deeper than that, looking at a tissue level, organ level, organ system level. That's approximately 100 trillion cells. And when we work on the cells, if cells are healthy, then the body's healthy. We have about 250 different types of cells, muscle cells, lung cells, liver cells, kidney cells, brain cells, and so on. We're really affecting all of those. And one of the reasons, or one of the ways we affect that is through the circulation. Increase the circulation. You've heard of ischemia?
Yes.
Ischemia, which means what?
Heart problem. Heart condition.
Ischemia referring to the blood. Ischemia basically means, literally translated, means lack of blood, but it really means compromised blood flow to the area. So we help to reverse that. Anytime somebody has a spasm, it's pain somewhere in the muscle. Part of that is due to ischemia. Think of a heart attack. Why do they have pain in the heart? Lack of blood flow.
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be blocked arteries, right? Occlusions. All right. And then, of course, the pair of 12 regular organ meridians. And the traditional Asian medicine that you'll be giving into, like the liver and the gallbladder, that's anger is associated with those organs. Your stomach and spleen, worry associated with those organs. Kidney, bladder, fear is associated with that, those organs. Lung, large intestine, is sadness or grief. Or in grief, you notice it affects your breathing, how you breathe. So which came first? That's, you know, chicken and the egg. Did the emotion come first? Or did the restriction in your breathing come first, which then triggered the emotion? That's all going to ask you.
Can I ask a quick question?
Yes.
So that means every organ is connected to an emotion?
Yes.
Wow.
And you can get much more into detail. That's just very basic. Yes. Mm. Louise Hay.
I was going to say, you should look up Louise Hay.
Yes.
She's very, I've got a book at home. It relates almost, not every, but so many things with emotional things.
Right. So, lower back pain. Lower back pain. Could be possibly feeling a lack of support. Knee pain. Could be feeling a lack of mobility to support yourself.
But also to move forward. To move forward with the knees. Anything
yes.
mobile.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So, there's many layers too. Yes, definitely.
Fears.
Fears?
Yes, when they say you get locked up. Like when you fear something, sometimes you need to get locked up.
Yes.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's medically
that's
documented.
Done.
That's not even just, you know.
I understand.
What's the lady name again? Or you said the name of the book?
Oh, well, you'll be going over traditional Chinese medicine. Or
oh, so we'll find that out later on.
And probably in your book, fundamentals, you do have a traditional Chinese
section in
the
book.
As well, this is your book. I did, those who weren't here, I found this book over here. It's really about grounding, earthing. That's what we're missing the name. From a yin yang viewpoint, or heaven earth viewpoint, we are in the center, heaven and earth. If we are grounded, unquote, we are nourished by both heaven and earth. The energies, electromagnetic energies, the prana, chi, ki, the kundalini, unquote, can move as well. Mm. All right, of course, we have, depending on how you count it, but we count it typically as 11 mind systems in the body. And we affect all of them. We affect one system, we affect all of them, craniosacral. For instance, if we're doing craniosacral, we're focused on the cranial sacral system, the cerebral spinal system. We affect that, really, through the domino effect, we affect everything else. If you do sleep massage, we increase the circulation, we increase the oxygen flow, nutrient flow. The qi flow, because one of the theories in traditional Asian medicine is that qi is in the blood. The blood is the mother of qi. And that energy goes to those cells, which of course affects the tissues and the organs and the systems and their functioning. So you're doing a lot when you do massage, very simple massage, simple resting position. You're doing a lot. This is what you're going to be learning.
Mm-hmm.
You have a coach, they coach you through it, to get all those layers, all the subtleties that's actually happening that we may not be conscious of. This happens. More is happening than we realize.
Mm-hmm.
We can say in our society, we're a touch deprived society. Can we say that? Touch deprived. Mm-hmm. How many times do you want to get?
Not much, but I'm a big fan.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not a part of our coaching. Most coaches.
There you go, I got, you got that all the time.
But it's true, like in Europe, I always hug and I kiss three times, depending on who you are.
But here is what?
Self-therapy,
too.
Yeah.
You're
so good. You don't even need that.
Yes.
If somebody's
that
nice to you,
that
you
can
manage them.
When you touch
them,
sometimes
it's
good not to
hug. Yeah,
that's going to be a question for you as therapist. After a session, client, a hug or not a hug? Well, shaking hands is good. That's the. Now, some cultures, also it's cultural.
Mm-hmm.
Some cultures don't shake hands. Some cultures don't look in the eye.
Yes.
Right? Some cultures forget about hugs.
Who is they? Like